No farmer wants to lose precious nutrients in the cool season, but this is exactly what happens when a field is left fallow. We visited with Penn State's Dr. Sjoerd Duiker to talk about how they use cover crops to ensure that those nutrients stay where they belong.
You know, in Pennsylvania, a special characteristic of our state is that we are very heavily reliant on the dairy sector, and our farms, they spread manure, and they spread it at times when there might not be living vegetation in the field. So the water-soluble portion of the nutrients can easily be lost. And we, being a large part of our state, is in the Chesapeake Bay watershed. So a lot, we are under scrutiny. There's a lot of concern about nutrient losses to the rivers, to the streams, and eventually to the Chesapeake Bay. There are basically two periods during the year that we lose a lot of nutrients. One is in the fall, there's a little peak, and then most of the, especially nitrogen loss, occurs in the spring. That time, April, May, when we come out of the winter, the soil starts to thaw, the soil saturated, mineralization is taking place, and now we get leaching through the soil profile. A lot of nitrogen is then lost to groundwater, and that eventually then through lateral flow ends up in the streams. So what we are trying to do is to have living cover crops that take up all those nutrients, the water-soluble nutrients, nitrogen primarily, is made available, and it's then absorbed by the roots. It's like a sponge, a continuous sponge that is there. We have evaluated the nutrient uptake, and what we can find in the above ground biomass, depending on growing conditions and the type of cover crop, but it can be even 200 pounds of nitrogen per acre into the above ground vegetation only. So yes, that makes up typically perhaps 80% of the total plant biomass. Okay. The rest is underground. All that would otherwise have been liable to loss. So what we are normally considering when we grow a full corn crop, we might assume that that corn crop needs 150 pounds of nitrogen, perhaps 200 pounds of nitrogen per acre. Okay. So we are trying to really stimulate that cycling of those nutrients and avoiding them from being lost from the system. We would like to see every acre of corn silage in the state be followed with cover crops. No more fallow after corn silage.